Hey everyone, what is up? The accessibility guy is back with you doing another video. And it is my second video of 2024, which is pretty exciting. And in this video I decided to talk about something that I want to talk about someday, and that day is today, and it will be my fifth time at getting it done, which will be a week from today, which the accessibility guy decided that today will be my last video for 2 weeks until February 8th of 2024, which is this year. And the reason is I will be taking those 2 weeks off from doing my videos is because next week is my dentist appointment to remove my 3 cavities. Don't know how I got them, because I brush my teeth every morning and night at the start and at the end of my day. Hopefully this is just a flu. Hopefully I won't have to get cavities again in my lifetime. So I could have been awake to get them removed, but my stupid tongue gets always in the way. So thoughts why I need to put under, and this is what my video is all about: what is general anesthesia and what does it do to the human body. So sit back and let the accessibility guy tell you all about what's general anesthesia. General anesthesia is treatment with medication to make you completely unconscious so that your body will be still for the duration and so that you will not feel pain. Modern technology and safety standards have made general anesthesia safe for most people. General anesthesia is a method of medically including loss of consciousness that renders a patient inarousable even with painful stimuli. This effect is achieved by administering either intravenous or inhalational general anesthetic medications, which often act in combination with an analgesic and neuromuscular blocking agent. Spontaneous ventilation is often inadequate during the procedure, and intervention is often necessary to protect the airway. General anesthesia is generally performed in an operating theater to allow surgical procedures that would otherwise be intolerably painful for a patient or in an intensive care unit or emergency department or ICU to facilitate endotracheal intubation and mechanical ventilation in critically ill patients, regardless of whether a patient may prefer to be unconscious or not. Certain pain stimuli could result in involuntary responses from the patient, such as movement or muscle contractions that may make an operation extremely difficult. Thus, for many procedures, general anesthesia is required from a practical perspective. Specialty is anesthesia. It uses our facilitating surgeries and terminal seduction. Complications are anesthesia awareness, overdose, and death, but these mishaps are very rarely to happen. I have been to the place 4 times before. I am not worried. I know the team there will do a great job. The first time I had it done, I was a bit nervous, to be honest. But now I ain't worried at all or nervous about it at all. MESH is D000768. Its MAD line plus is 007410. General anesthesia is a variety of drugs may be administered with the overall goal of achieving unconsciousness, amnesia, analgesia, loss of reflexes of the autonomic nervous system, and in some cases paresis or skeletal muscles. The optimal combination of anesthetics for any given patient and procedure is typically selected by an anesthetist or another provider, such as a nurse anesthetist, depending on local practice and law. So in other words, general anesthesia only be administered to the patient, which will be me next week, by a nurse anesthetist. in consultation with the patient and the surgeon or dentist or other practitioner performing the operative procedure. In other words, a dentist or someone else can administer the anesthesia to the patient because the anesthetist knows how much of the sleeping gas and what amount to give to the patient. Here is some history about general anesthesia. Attempts at producing a state of general anesthesia can be traced throughout recorded history of the writings of the Phoenicians, Sumerians, Babylonians, Assyrians, Egyptians, Greeks, Romans, Indians, and Chinese. During the Middle Ages, scientists and other scholars made significant advances in the Eastern world, while their European counterparts also made important advances. The Renaissance saw significant advances in anatomy and surgical technique. However, despite all this progress, surgery remained a treatment of last resort. Largely because of the associated pain, many patients chose certain death rather than undergo surgery. Although there has been a great deal of debate as to who deserves the most credit for the discovery of general anesthesia, several scientific discoveries in the late 18th and early 19th centuries were critical to the eventual introduction and development of modern anesthesia techniques. Two enormous leaps occurred in the late 19th century, which together allowed the transition to modern surgery. An appreciation of the germ theory of de Sessi led rapidly to the development and application of antiseptic techniques in surgery. Antisepsis, which soon gave way to asepsis, reduced the overall morbidity and mortality of surgery to a far more acceptable rate than in previous eras. Concurrent with these developments were the significant advances in pharmacology and physiology, which led to the development of general anesthesia and the control of pain. On November 14th of 1804, so that would have been 220 years ago, which was 9 years after Oak Island in Nova Scotia was found. Sorry, got a little sidetracked there, because around the time Oak Island was found, but later I can tell you all about the show called The Curse of Oak Island, and it's getting really exciting now, but they already found the big treasure. They over the years trying to find ways on extending the TV show because of the ratings, but this is not the topic for today's video. Back to topic, so here I go. Where did I left off? Drink some of my coffee before I continue, while my vodka is getting tired from all of this talking. Hanayokasi Ishii, which is the name of a person, he is a Japanese surgeon, became the first person on record to successfully perform surgery using general anesthesia. Wow, that's a super cool fact. I love learning about history of things like this. Hey, maybe that one class for me to take for my second term of my third year of school online. I think that is a great one. Thanks, me, I love myself because I haven't done history in a while since during my second year, which was last year. Any was moving on in the 20th century, the safety and efficacy of general anesthesia was improved by the routine use of tracheal intubation and other advanced airway management techniques, significant advances in monitoring and new anesthetic agents with improved pharmacokinetic and pharmacodynamic characteristics also contributed to this trend. Finally, CERN Dead Eyes training programs for anesthesiologists and nurse anesthetists emerged during this period. The purpose of general anesthesia has many purposes and is routinely used in almost all surgical procedures, like, for example, at the dentist, but not for getting your teeth done. An appropriate surgical anesthesia should include the following goals. 1. Hypnosis or unconsciousness, which is loss of awareness like the concept of time. And it's like almost like time travel in a way, but it's not that patients think that they are. You feel like you just got put under and had a cat 5-minute nap, but really it turns out to be 1 hour and a half or 3 hours goes by. I really like being put under and I don't feel nervous at all. A team of doctors and nurses look after you and you are attached to a blood pressure thingy and a heart rate monitor. It's pretty cool how it all works. Anyways, so number 4 is immobility, which is loss of motor reflexes, and the final Number 2 purpose of general anesthesia is analgesia, which is loss of response of pain. Number 3 is amnesia, which is loss of memory. Okay, playing amnesia by 5 seconds of summer. No Siri, no sorry for this, guys. Hey Siri, turn Apple Music off. Okay, the accessibility guy. Sometimes I start to wonder, was it just a lie? If what we have is real, how could you be fine? Cause I'm not fine at all. When the day you told me you were leaving, I'm gonna get by again, and I'm gonna get my Anyways, so number 4 is immobility, which is loss of motor reflexes, and the final purpose of general anesthesia is paralysis, which is skeletal muscle relaxation and normal muscle relaxation. Instead of resolving continuous deep sedation such as via benzodiazepines, dying patients may choose to be completely unconscious as they die. Wow, thoughts really interesting to me. I wonder if animals like dogs and cats get the same thing as us humans do. Wow, this is pretty cool. I am reading this really cool information on Wikipedia. And thank you the team at Wikipedia for letting me use your resource like a lot of YouTubers do all over the world, so they will have got something to talk about on YouTube filming their videos. So thanks for providing us with this resource. Otherwise, we will have got nothing to talk about on our videos to share the rest of the world with. Come to think of it, this gives me an idea name for one of my future videos on my channel about how was the internet and Google created and in what year did we have all of these social media and sites like Google, YouTube, Facebook, Facebook Messenger, and TikToks and Netflix and whatnot. Thanks me again for that awesome idea. Now back to this. I am on the headline called Biochemical Mechanism of Action. The biochemical mechanism of action of general anesthetics is still controversial. There always need to explain the function of anesthesia in animals. Now here we go. Good, I am wondering about this. And plants. While plants as well, how I am a little confused, let's read on. To induce unconsciousness, anesthetics have myriad sites of action and affect the ventral nervous system, which short form is CNS, at multiple levels. General anesthesia commonly interprets or changes the functions of CNS components, including the cerebral cortex, thalamus, reticular activating system, and spinal cord. Current theories on the anesthetized state identify not only target sites in the CNS, but also neural networks and arousal circuits linked with unconsciousness, and some anesthetics potentially able to activate specific sleep-active regions. Two non-exclusionary mechanisms include membrane-mediated and direct protein-mediated anesthesia. Potential protein-mediated molecular targets are GABA and NMD glutamate receptors. General anesthesia was hypothesized to either enhance the inhibitory transmission or reduce the excitatory transmission or of neurosignaling. Most suggest they could target the plasma membrane. E.brand-mediated H-anism that could account for the activation of an ion channel remained elusive until recently. A study from 2020, which was 4 years ago, demonstrated that inhaled anesthetics coloform and isoflurane could displace phospholipase from ordered lipid domains in the plasma membrane, which led to the production of the signaling molecule phosphatidic acid, which is the short form of PIA. The signaling molecule activated TWIK-related K-plus channels, which is short form of TRK-1, a channel involved in anesthesia. PL fruit flies were shown to resist anesthesia. The results established a membrane-mediated target for inhaled anesthetics. You can read online the selection on Wikipedia called Preoperative Evolution. I am running out of time here to cover off this part, and there's a lot more here about general anesthesia. I just will read throughout this part because I want to read about this part. Okay, so as a brief summary of what I read, they let you know not to eat anything after midnight or drink anything 6 hours in advance for a big procedure, but for small procedures like dental surgery, like what I will have next week, don't eat anything after midnight or don't drink anything, like water or juice or coffee, 3 to 4 hours before the procedure. I kind of already know this from last 4 times, otherwise if you eat 11 hours before your procedure or drink anything 3, 6 hours before, you will run into anesthesia awareness and lead to serious complications such as death, but death is really rare. Don't be worried, anyone watching me in the world, don't be scared about this. Just obey the rules and you will be totally fine. So this is my last note on my vocus, so I need to finish up this. So let's see, I will skip the next part about premedication, only will read it myself like I did with the last part. What, hold on a minute here, I don't remember having some drugs in me before I got put under, maybe I don't remember it. I thought it's just the mask and the needle, then I am comatose. So anyways, but I know that general anesthesia is made up with about 5 different drugs combined into one, and they are called isoglurine, propofol, enflurane, nitrous oxide, and fentanyl. I said, wait, what, fentanyl is used in general anesthesia, but if someone takes too much of that stuff, it will kill them. That reminds me, let me see if I can find it on their YouTube channel. And their YouTube channel is called W5, which about wow oh my, so for 9 years already since season 39 I remembered that in a year. From then would been their special 50th anniversary of doing the show, and wow, now let me see if I can remember the very first episode of W5 that I had watched. Wow, I think I remember it was after I turned 18, just after I turned that age. Come on, the accessibility guy think. Wow, that episode about fentanyl was my very first episode of W5 that I ever watched in my life. Wow, and it was season 39 ep. Hang on, that was not the episode I have watched as my first show ever at W5. It was season 39 episode 9, and it aired on October 16th of 2014. Wow, I might just have to watch it for my 10th year in university. That episode wow brings back memories. Looks like time is up. Sometime in the near future we'll do a part 2 of what is general anesthesia, because it looks really interesting to learn all about this. Well, I use my voice to end this.